Hi folks, so I've stated before, this month I started my second and final year as a graduate student majoring in social work, and in light of that, I've come up with some rules and expectations for myself for the new school year. It's kind of resolutions. I know people usually do it, you know, in the new years, but I don't really think there's a specific time that we should do it. I think for me, it's a good time to do it. It's my new school year resolutions. And these are things that I will expect of myself to kind of keep up with or strive to do throughout the school year to be a pretty good, productive student and just good person overall for me. You know, these are the things that I think are pretty challenging for me. They might sound really basic and stupid to a lot of you guys, but anyway, I have 7 things that I put up here. And so just let me just start. So number 1 is don't wake up later than 8 a.m. Like I said, this is probably basic to many of you guys. I think a lot of people that I know are morning people. They're the early birds. They get up in the morning and they go to sleep at the right early time, and they can kind of function on the normal 9-to-5 or 8-to-4 schedule. To me, I think this one, don't wake up later than 8 a.m., this might be the most challenging one for me. It's a big deal to me because I've always been very naturally nocturnal. And I've had jobs with graveyard shifts, and I really like that. I think my body still kind of prefers that schedule of 12 midnight to 8 in the morning. Or sometimes I had a shift where, you know, I go into work at 12 at midnight and then I get out of work at 4 in the afternoon. Staying awake when everyone else is asleep, I don't know, there's something that always been like really empowering about that, to be that, to that one lone unique person. It feels unique, feels nice, and my body just is so pumped up at night. But I need to dial that down, obviously, because almost everybody else in this world kind of operates in a more normal schedule when the sun is up. So I'm going to try my best this school year to not have such a weird, crazy sleeping pattern that I usually have done. So because all my classes are in the normal hours, my internship is 9-to-5, and I'm pretty sure that after I graduate, all the social work jobs that are available for me, or almost all of them that I want to get into, are going to require the normal 9-to-5 or 8-to-4 schedule. So it's right now, I just got to make sure that I get ready to have the normal sleeping schedule. It really sucks to be an outlier in this one, that I'm not like most people and I prefer to be nocturnal. But, you know, I have to kind of adapt or adjust to what society dictates, I suppose. Number 2, don't spend more than $50 a week on food. So this one I actually think is tough for many other people, but for me, this actually should be really easy for me. A few years back, 4 years ago, I started being vegan. And then my second year, I did so good. My food expense, the amount of money I spent on food, on average, every month was like $110 a month. So if I split that every week, that's like $25 a week or something like that, or $30 a week. Sometimes even less. That was my average my second year as a vegan. I think that was because I was under this assumption that, you know, oh, it's so impossible to find anything to eat outside. You know, no restaurants are going to serve me vegan food. There's no eateries out there that has vegan food. So I rarely ate out. You know, I went to the local store and I bought ingredients and vegetables. And then I just prepared my food at home. And that just saves so much money. Not eating out is does wonders for your wallet. And so that had a unintended kind of bonus effect on my food expense being really low. Over the recent years, I come to discover that assumption is wrong. I'm in New York City, so there are great vegan places that I've discovered. And then I also discovered Seamless, which is a great service, but kind of like, oh man, I discovered this, which delivers food right to my home just by tapping my touchscreen a few times on my iPad app. And then, you know, food just gets delivered to my home. And then, you know, $12 or $15 just went out of my debit card. Holy crap. So because of that, I ended up spending a lot of money on food last year. So realizing that, I think I have to go back to my roots of being more frugal and self-reliant and do more cooking and preparing food at home and less time eating outside, you know. So far, I'm doing really good. This August, just this month, I calculated it. I spent $130 on food just this month of August. So that's pretty good. That's way lower than $50 a week on food at the most. That's my goal this year, to not spend more than $50 a week on food on average, really, per month. So this August, $130 in food. I used Seamless once. That's it. I just used once for a falafel sandwich that I had delivered. But that's it. You know, I'm staying good so far. Number three, write at least one thing a day. So this one I think is good for me because I think writing is one of the most productive, creative actions that I'm capable of. For some reason, I really like writing, but I haven't been able to write. I've been really lazy with writing stuff over the past 2 years, I think, over the past recent years. So I should do more of it, I think. At least one like blog or an article or even just like a Facebook long post. I think that's like a worthwhile goal. There's a lot that's in my mind, I think, and it's good to kind of share, just kind of online and have a discussion, or not even not, or just to kind of put it out there. I think that's really important to put my what I think on paper. I'm sure because I'm gonna do one a day, I'm sure there's gonna be some days when I can't think of what to write, like, oh my gosh, I have nothing to write about. But I suppose, I guess that'll be the challenge of this. Although, I think I'm gonna give myself break on the weekends, like, I'm not gonna say, you know, write at least one thing a day, except maybe on the weekends, you know? Weekends are just like, whatever. Speaking of weekends, number four. Video games are only for weekends. So, only play video games on the weekends. That's my number four resolution. Oh man, that one's gonna be tough. So, I've come to own a lot of video games, and a lot of them I still haven't even begun to play. There's Ni No Kuni here, Dishonored, Super Mario Galaxy 2, I think I played 2 hours of that. I still have to play more. Beyond Two Souls, I actually own these games. Even games I own right now, I haven't played. That they're yet to be. They're begging me to play. But then I have all these other things. I'm going through Borderlands 2 and Assassin's Creed 4 right now. So, oh man, so many amazing games, and I haven't had the time to play them. And so limiting myself to weekends is just gonna be a challenge. So video games I just find so compelling. I can spend hours playing them. So it's a really bad destruction. Destruction? No, bad distraction. As a college student, I'm constantly tempted to play. So yeah, I'm gonna have to limit myself. It's gonna be hard. I think there are gonna be times when I kind of like, oh man, like I'm itching to play. So maybe if I do end up playing on the weekday, maybe the resolution should be I don't play more than an hour if I do so. But that should be like almost never happens. I don't know. Let's see how this happens. This resolution, I'm like really kind of concerned about how I'm gonna try to keep this up. But only for the weekends. I mean, that's my limit. Number five, be more involved with other students and coworkers. This seems like a very basic one or pretty general or broad one, but it's really because last year I feel like I didn't really interact that much with my colleagues and coworkers outside of school or work. And part of that was because really I was really overwhelmed the first year as a graduate student. I was really busy with a lot of things, so it was kind of overwhelming to try to connect with people outside of work and school. So now I'm looking back and I realize I really should have been more involved with other fellow social work students and coworkers. So this year I kind of started just kind of being more involved. I was a student leader for the orientation week. And I'm now just joined as a member of the student collective for global social work. I'm trying to figure out ways to get more involved. I'm starting to get in better touch with a few of my colleagues that I'm pretty close to now. So this is my final year as a graduate student. Before I graduate and go into the work world, I think it's really important that I build and establish a good social network. I guess that's kind of the thing to worry about now. So, you know, that's definitely something I need to keep in mind this year. Speaking of, it's weird, you know. I'm a social work student. That's my passion, but sometimes I can be so introverted and shy. So it's kind of a, I don't know if it's something you call ironic, but that's kind of the fact about me. Number six, it's kind of related. Call my parents at least twice a week. So yeah, I know this is included in the list. This kind of shows that I'm not that great of a son to my parents. Let me try to explain. It's just that when I call my mom, and this is a horrible, weird explanation. When I call my mom, she can really talk and talk and talk and talk and talk. So one phone call to her, it can take an hour or 2 hours. It can take a long time just on the phone. You know, I love my mom, but that can be really daunting, say honestly, if I'm being honest and frank. My dad's the opposite. He doesn't really like talking on the phone that much. So if I call him, our conversations on the phone are really quick and they end really abruptly. Like, you know, it's just like, oh, hey son, are you eating okay? Yeah, I'm eating okay. And then he gives advice, tells me to go to church. And then that's kind of the phone conversation. It ends really quickly. I don't think I've ever had a phone conversation longer than like 10 minutes is like one time that was rare, but over 5 minutes doesn't happen. So it's like the exact opposite. And it's kind of really awkward talking with my dad on the phone because it ends like that. Either way, what happens is I end up not calling my mom or dad until my mom calls me a lot more often, my dad less so. But, you know, I do realize I'm an only child, so my parents live in different states. So, you know, it is kind of like, and I have this Korean culture thing, you know, obligation and respect to elders and parents. So there is an obligation there to kind of be more involved in their lives and be more present. And then I'll make another video in which I talk about the fact that I'm a 1.5 generation immigrant. That's its own thing. And the responsibilities and burdens of that is kind of interesting to talk about, I think. Maybe it might be. I don't know. Maybe. Don't know why I do these videos sometimes if they're not interesting to you guys. I just do them. But, yeah, so that's kind of a resolution. I'm going to try to be more in touch with my parents, call them at least twice a week. sounds like a simple resolution, shouldn't be too hard, I think. But just goes to show you that, yeah, I was not doing that last year. So definitely need to be more, keep in frequent contact with my parents. And so the last resolution, number seven, pretty simple one. Don't get behind on class readings. So this one's obvious. I'm a graduate student. And all my classes give me a lot of readings. They assign me a lot of readings, a lot of articles, a lot of books to read. Last year, if I had to like average it out, I think I had to read about 300 pages per week. I think that was my average, I'm not sure. And sometimes a lot more than that, you know. So, of course, the problem is with that much reading, you know, I kind of fell behind sometimes, some weeks. So this year, I gotta just make sure that doesn't ever happen. You know, I gotta stay up to date and try to make a good schedule of like, okay, so today I'm going to be doing readings for this class for this many hours. Yeah, that's gotta be a resolution. Don't get behind on class readings. These are the seven resolutions I have for myself. I try to think of come up with ones that were really important for me as a graduate student now. So final year. But not only that, I try to think of ones that are really doable. You know, I think sometimes we make the mistake of making our resolutions too ambitious. So for me, these are really ambitious and challenging resolutions, especially the video game one. But I think they're pretty doable. You know, if I mess this up, then it's kind of like I have no excuse. You know, I was just like, oh man, I made good resolutions, but I wasn't able to keep it up. I don't know how to explain myself. So I'm putting that on public. These are my resolutions for the new school year, and I'll keep you guys updated on how I do on that. Wish me luck, I suppose. But yeah, this is my beginning of my second and final year as a graduate student. Hopefully I do well and graduate. So, cheers.